let's talk about United States versus Newman. Even after the Supreme Court's recent Salmon case, it still matters. The way tipping cases normally work is one guy gives information to another guy. Then the second guy trades on that information and then returns some sort of benefit to the first guy. But sometimes you'll have one guy talking to another guy who talks to another guy who talks to sometimes a woman, but it seems like usually another guy. Lots of links in that chain. Newman was this kind of case. It involved 2008 quarterly earnings reports for two companies, Dell and NVIDIA. The Dell information tree looked like this, and the NVIDIA chain looked like this. Here were all the people. A few were common to both. Anyway, as I was saying, lots of dudes. But let's focus on the NVIDIA chain for now. At NVIDIA, a finance unit staff member named Chris Choi tipped information to Hyung Lim, whom he knew from church. Lim passed that information to Danny Kuo, an analyst at Whittier Trust. Kuo circulated the information to a group of analyst friends, including Jesse Tortora at Diamondback Capital and Sam Adendakis at Level Global Investors. Those guys then passed the information to their bosses, portfolio managers Todd Newman and Anthony Chiasson at Diamondback and Level Global, respectively. Chiasson and Newman then traded on that information to make $68 and $4 million for Level Global and Diamondback. Now, you may have noticed that it's kind of a long way between Newman and Chiasson over here and NVIDIA's Chris Choi over here. This was a problem at trial and on appeal. The court's jury instruction on this issue focused on the defendant's knowledge of the original insider's breach of his duty of trust and confidentiality. The defendants were super disappointed with that instruction because they thought it was not the law. Remember, tipping cases require a personal benefit going back to the original tipper. And the defendants argued that to be guilty, they needed to have known what that personal benefit was. But the government had no evidence they had any idea what the personal benefits in this case were. This bugged the Court of Appeals a lot. And it should have, because an insider's disclosure of confidential information is not enough by itself to amount to a breach of fiduciary duty. We just learned that in Volume 13, the Barry Switzer story. The court went back to Dirks versus SEC to define a breach of fiduciary duty in this context to be a breach of confidentiality in exchange for a personal benefit. Putting it another way, you can't have a breach of fiduciary duty without a personal benefit going back to the original tipper. So this instruction focused more narrowly on a breach of confidentiality wasn't enough, and the convictions of Newman and Chiasson were overturned. We'll talk next time about what the Court of Appeals held as to what counts as a personal benefit in tipping cases.